starts off with a quick opening statement. Please raise your hands for questions.
You know, when you look at the review of the Florida game, obviously everybody in the program is disappointed. You know, just starting offensively, some positives. To me, I feel like we had four offensive linemen that played winning football in that game. That's the first time since we've been here that we've had that. So these guys continue to progress up front, which is a positive sign. Got to get more guys that can do that. You know, so this week, Chris Aparigny is back and is having an opportunity to practice. Another guy that can possibly plug in there and we'll play sometime here in the future. You know, there's one thing that we have to do offensively is we can't turn the football over Saturday. We had four turnovers, you know, in the first four games we've had eight, and we're 2 for 8 on fourth down. So that's 6 times we turn over the ball on downs. We going into the season, we said we had to have minimal turnovers and we need to be opportunistic on defense, you know. Had a couple of balls there that we would have liked to have had back, you know. Had a chance there early in the game in the red area to stick one in and didn't do that. And twice had a couple of guys running to me for touchdowns that we've got to be able to get these guys the ball. And we see that, we know that, okay? And defensively, you know, if you look at the game, I thought the guys fought really hard, played well together. We've kind of done our quality control for the first four games. You know, if we've had one guy on a play, if we've given up a play, one guy that may not have played the right technical part, okay, or may have made a mental error there. So when you look at statistically, it's a lot of really good, but the plays that we've left out there, we've got to eliminate. We've yet to give up a play because of lack of ability. And we have in the last two games gotten 8 turnovers. We've got to continue to do that. Had a chance to get a 9th one on Saturday, but we were out of bounds there. So, you know, going into this week, what do we do? You know, our guys have went to work. We've had 2 really good spirited practices, guys working extremely hard. You know, last year we had an off week at this time and improved a lot as a football team. So we go back to the basics, and that's what we're working on. You know, as a coaching staff, you sit there and look and say, okay, what have we done well through the first four games, okay? Maybe what have we not done so well? We don't need to do that in the world, or why are we not doing it well? Or is there a personnel issue? Is there guys that maybe have not played to the standard that you expected? Or maybe there's some younger guys that are kind of, you know, it's getting to this the 5th week of the season. Maybe they're starting to get where they're ready to play now. So it's a great opportunity for everybody in our program to continue to improve, and our guys are doing that. You know, I think one of the hot topics in college football is the transfer portal, right? So, you know, and we've had some guys enter the transfer portal. You know, I said this before, when we, in the first year of our program, we had very few guys leave, right? It's because there was hope, you know. Year two, as more guys get into the program and you look and see, you know, guys want to leave because they want to have an opportunity to play. I get it. And I think you've seen that all over college football. I'm sitting here every night fielding phone calls from people, you know, hey, my son's going to be in the transfer portal, or we got a player from our team that's going to the transfer portal. This really changes really the dynamic of college football. And I'm not sure anybody's got a grasp on it yet. So, but it's there, you deal with it, and you coach the guys that are within your program. With that, I'll take any questions.
Brent and Mike Wilson, Brent Hubbs.
Coach, you made it clear throughout the summer and fall camp that Jared was your quarterback. As you move into this week with what you were talking about in terms of get the ball to your playmakers, where is that quarterback competition? How do you manage him? How do you manage your quarterbacks this week and moving forward?
Well, I think it's just like every position. You know, every position on our team, there's been times this year that we played really good football, okay? But we're looking for consistency, you know, and that's with every position. So every week, you know, we play the guys that give us the best opportunity to have success. And we'll continue to do that. You know, hey, Jared has not been probably as good as he would like to be on certain times, but he's also made some really good throws and made some really good decisions. No different than maybe the defensive line, linebackers, secondary, or whatever. Everybody in our program's got to raise their level. We've got to be more consistent, and we've got to create the right habits so it shows up on game day.
Mike and Wes and Steve.
Jeremy, Corvarius Crouch at running back, is that something you guys like situationally or something you might expand? And what does he bring to the table that's different from the other running backs you have?
Well, the first thing is he weighs 248 pounds and they weigh 205 pounds. So when it's third and one or fourth and one, that would be an option. It's something that we talked about doing when we recruited him. I mean, he rushed for 3,000 yards his junior year in high school, so the guy can play running back. He came here to play linebacker with the thought that he'd have an opportunity on short yardage and goal line. He got a little banged up in fall camp, so we did have an opportunity to work on that package because we worry about ball security, right? So it took us a little bit of time to get it in there, but hopefully moving forward we can do that.
Wes, Steve, Patrick.
Jeremy, when y'all break down some of the throws Jared has made at times in the past week, or in the past, I guess, this season. On some of those throws that haven't gone right, is it maybe some sort of a technique issue or technical thing, or where his eyes are, or thinking too much, or what's been some of the discussions there about some of the errant throws?
Well, you know, there's a lot that goes into the quarterback position. You know, I played in high school, coached a lot when I was as a younger coach, you know, so. Starts with protections, right? Okay, starts there. And lots of times we put that on the quarterback to make sure that we get the protections right, okay? So he's got to know where he's protected from, and he's done a nice job of that most of the year. The next thing is for every pattern, whether it's a progression read or whether it's middle field open or middle field closed, you have a starting place and you have an ending place. You got to know where you're starting and what your key is, right? So, that's every single pass play. You have to do all that with a timing mechanism and understand that. There's probably been some times maybe we didn't start in the right spot, okay? Or maybe we need to speed up our footwork or some things like that. So, or hey, maybe there was a little bit of pressure. Maybe you couldn't step up in the pocket, you know? Because sometimes what you see on film when you go back there and stand behind the old lineman, if you can get a little bit of push, sometimes it makes it tough on the quarterback. So I know for us defensively, that's one of the things is if you make guys throw from out of the pocket, they don't have limits to step up in there, it makes it more difficult for them.
Steve and Patrick.
There have been reports that Chuck S. Jones, Shannon Reed had entered the transfer portal. I was just checking to see if they officially left the team or if this is a situation like Garland where they're exploring their options. And if they have left, I didn't know, other than those two and Will, if there are any other players.
Yeah, no, they left.
Patrick, then Jimmy.
Jeremy, you said on the teleconference that you had some young offensive linemen that have started to have been improving and showing through over the last few weeks. Who are some of those guys? What do you see for them moving forward?
Well, you look, Darnell Wright and Wanye Morris have continued to work hard and improve, okay? Are they where they need to be yet? No. But they continue to work hard. Jackson Lampley worked hard at practice. Chris Aparigny continues to improve. So, Saturday, Brandon Kennedy has gotten better every week. Because Brandon's a fifth-year guy, Brandon's not played a lot of ball because he's been hurt most of his career. He continues to play, and Saturday was his best game. Trey continues to improve, which you would think he would based off, as the games go, Riley Locklear is another guy that continues to improve. So our guys are working hard. We're getting better up front, every one of them. So we've got to continue to do that and build upon.
Jimmy, then David.
Jimmy, the quarterback at Houston has decided to redshirt after playing four games, and I wondered your reaction to that, saying he's going to come out next year. What's your reaction to that, and is it something you've ever considered with any of your players?
Well, we did it last year, you know.
I mean, after four games, where a good player says, hey, I'm going to redshirt and then come out next year.
Well, I don't know the circumstances, so it's hard for me to comment on that, but I know last year when we had four games left, there were several guys on our team, Kevon Bennett, Prime Garland, Kingston Harris, Greg Emerson, Cedric Tillman. There were some guys there that we elected not to play in the last few games, so they would gain another year of eligibility. I don't know his circumstance. I know their circumstance, but before we did it, I talked to them and I called their parents to make sure that we were all on the same page. I felt like it would give them an opportunity, you know, if they wanted that fifth year down the road, they'd be thankful for. Hey, I look at it like this. Coached a lot of guys that made no impact on the team that they represented through 4 years, okay? In their fifth year, they became starters, and they play in the NFL today. So, circumstances, whether it's maturity, whether it's physical or mental maturity, people kind of grow and develop it at different times in their life. And so that's why it's important to keep young guys in your program, to have an opportunity to have success one day. Unfortunately, it's different, you know, now than when we grew up. Now you can put something on social media and in 3 seconds everybody out in California know what, you know, they see what you put out there. Now, used to everything when we were growing up was spread by word of mouth. Took a long time to get it spread, you know.
David and Blake.
Jimmy, the quality control analysis that you talked about in the call on today, what does that kind of look like? What are you looking for, and how often have you done that this year?
Well, we do it after every game, but one thing we have an off week here, you know, defensively, you want to go. So we play with regular personnel, usually against regular people, okay, whether it's two tight ends and one back, or nobody hardly plays with a fullback anymore. But we play nickel personnel, and then we play nickel rabbits personnel versus 11 people on offense. So, and we have some of the same calls, right? So, we play dime rabbits and a couple other personnel against things on third down. So you want to see what you're having success doing, okay? When we're playing a four-man rush and playing middle field zone, okay? What's their success per play in run and pass? You're playing a four-man rush and you're playing quarter-quarter halves or quarter-quarters or whatever, right? You go through every call that you have and you see, has this been a good call for us or has it not? If it's not, how come? You know, are the numbers skewed because of one play? Say, hey, maybe it's been a good call for us, but based off the numbers, it's not just because of this one play, right? So you do that during the season. You do it after the season. It helps you with personnel, maybe who's playing well, who's not, what's the best personnel we need to move to for the rest of the year. You do it on both sides of the ball. You look at explosive plays that we've given up. Why? What's the cause that we've given them up in, the personnel, who gave them up, and why. You look at turnovers, for us, how are we creating turnovers. And you do it in all three phases, okay? You also have to go back and look at our personnel, okay? Where are people at right now? We have lots of guys that have not played a lot of ball for us yet. You might see them just a little bit in the first couple of games, but they're inching up there to get ready to play and to contribute, which will give us more depth. You know, it's interesting. We have Last 2 days, I'm meeting with every group of our players each day. It's something that we do a lot. And, you know, we have like 114 or 15 guys in our program, but 80 of them are freshmen and sophomores. So this is a wonderful week for these guys to continue to grow and develop and improve as a football player, to take that next step. So they can play, maybe if they've been playing, maybe they can play a little better, or they can put themselves in position ready to contribute.
Blake, and then Jesse and Brent.
Jerry, I have two questions. One with Donwood Anderson. I know he was dealing with a foot deal. Was, I hadn't seen him out there at practice yesterday. Was that what was going on with him?
No, his foot's fine. We had a couple of guys. You know, one of the big things here is academics, right? Everybody comes here. The number one thing is to get your degree. Okay. So our motto is it's school and football. You know. So Don's a guy that this is his last year. He wants to have an opportunity to graduate. So this is a good time to do that. You know, guys played really good football for us so far this year. So it's also a great opportunity to take Princeton Fan, Jackson Lowe, Sean Brown, Hunter Salmon, and give those guys a ton of work.
But Dom's status with the program is?
Oh, yeah.
And my second question, again, do you believe you have the talent to be competitive in the SEC this year? And if so, what needs to happen to kind of translate some of that talent to where you're seeing it on the field a little bit more?
Yeah, I mean, it's not hard to figure out. In the three games that we've lost, y'all watch the games. You know, we had an opportunity to win two of them, okay? And, you know, the first game we had five turnovers, whether it was three turnovers like we had or two turnovers on downs on fourth and one, right? And didn't, only got one, so we're minus four in the turnover margin there. It's hard to win that way. Probably left some plays out there on both sides of the ball. Our football team is 100 times better than it was this time last year, okay? Our guys are working hard. We're stronger, we're more physical. But when it comes to having success winning the football game, you can't turn the ball over and you have to create turnovers. And that's something that has hampered us in our three losses. Our guys are working hard. We're getting better on the offensive front. Our tight ends are playing winning football. We've got to be able to get the balls to our skilled players, okay? Be more consistent there. Defensively, it's unusual as you look at our defense, and through what we call explosive plays, getting gains of 20 yards or more, 15 on runs, 20 yards on passes, probably through four games, I think we've given up it's either 11 or 13, okay? For a team that's 1-3, that's not a whole lot, okay? So if you look at us, we've not given up as much of chunks as we've given up 7 to 14-yard plays, if that makes sense. So what does that mean? That means we need to be a little stronger when we tackle folks and knock folks back. Maybe our coverage is not hardly tight enough in some scenarios. We have created some negative plays. We've got to develop a little more pass rush when we rush with just four guys so we don't put so much stress on the back end. So all these things that we're looking at to find a way to improve.
Jeremy, you said the quarterback position is no different than every other position on the team. So have the reps changed at all, though, this week in terms of Jarrett, Brian, and JT? Has it kind of been status quo of what it was through the first month of the season?
No, I think we have to change the reps, okay? We have to do that. And it's no secret. There's no secrets anymore. We've got to get better production out of that position just like we do all of them. We've got to give these guys an opportunity, and this is a good chance to do that this week.
And what has that looked like, I guess, through the first 2 days thus far?
Everybody gets the same amount of reps.
Brent and Austin.
Coach, when you talk about, the best player each week is going to play, that creates, obviously, sometimes a change in your starting lineups. With young players, how hard is that to get them to understand that it's a week-to-week deal and it's not a, because you started last week, you're going to start this week, or because you played a lot last week, that's going to continue? Is that hard for a young football team to understand that approach?
Well, I'm sure it probably is, because probably most of them, because they were the better players on their team in high school, they probably played the same amount. It didn't matter how they practiced, you know, at most programs. You know, that's why you see, you don't see as many freshmen play at a high level, you know. They're more of it's rare that you see it. You see a lot of them that kind of show up, but it's usually about this time of the year that you start, there's more and more freshmen that kind of start showing up. It's on every team, right? It gives them, because what you see is a coach lots of times is you see the potential in fall camp, and school starts, it's kind of the grind, right? And they maybe disappear a little bit, and then that fifth, sixth, seventh week they start showing back up, they kind of get their feet back under them, and here they go. So I think we played 17 guys. You know, we might play more than that, and we'll continue to push those guys out there.
Austin, then Trey.
Coach, you talk about this week being big for all the, you know, younger kids on the team. How do you balance getting quality work in versus giving them a little time to rest and recuperate and get ready for this next stretch, and you guys being able to go out on the road and be visible out there recruiting?
Well, the rest part's not a problem. The thing that we have to look at is when you talk about depth at certain positions, you know, we don't have the depth that we need at certain positions. So, you know, you have to be careful there. But the rest part, these guys are fine, you know. As far as recruiting, we do that every single day. We'll go out on the road on Friday and do that. So give them 2 days off on Friday and Saturday, and they'll be back in here on Sunday getting ready for Georgia.
Trey, and then last couple, Wes.
Coach, how do you think offensive line protection has been when you guys are trying to throw the ball downfield, trying to use your weapons like Jennings and Callaway and Palmer on the outside? How do you think the offensive line has protected so far, 4 games in, compared to the game plan that you guys are trying to put together?
You know, I think our guys have really done a nice job. Could we improve? Sure we could. We need to be a little bit firmer inside. Probably need to be more consistent outside. You know, but we've not had to, you know, keep a bunch of guys in to chip and 7-man protection. We've done that some, but, you know, our guys have worked hard and continue to improve there. And it to me, it shows up on Saturday.
Last couple, Wes and Jimmy.
Jimmy, a couple things. One, with Theo Jackson, he's a guy who, I guess when you watch him on film, just doesn't look like the same guy that he looked like for parts of last year. And I'm wondering when you started seeing a change in him, you know, being more disruptive and doing things on the back end, and also what you thought of Bryce Thompson's first game back.
You know, Theo, he works hard every day. He's a smart guy. He knows what to do. He puts himself in the right spots, you know. He gives himself a chance to have success. He's a good communicator in the back end. He tried to play with some toughness. I thought he tackled well on Saturday in space. He missed one tackle down on the goal line, but made some plays on the ball in the back end. You know, Bryce, you know, he played better as the game went, which is expected, right? I mean, guys not been in a competitive game. So he got better as the game went.
Jimmy, last question.
Jimmy, you have a lot of players on your team that have been in the program for a number of years that did not have a lot of success. Do you think right now you have a team that simply does not play with much confidence?
Well, here's the thing. To me, when we lose a game, doesn't matter wherever I've ever coached, hadn't been used to losing very many of them, but it hurts pretty bad, okay? I think sometimes you can get numb to losing, right? If it happens over and over again, maybe you get used to it. And that's something that there's lots of guys in our program that aren't used to losing, okay? And it hurts them, all right? But I'm not saying the guys in our program are that way, but I do think that can happen, you know? So I can tell you this, our football team, I've said all along that I like this group of guys. The guys work extremely hard, okay? You know, there's lots of things. We need to coach them up better, okay? We need to play a little better. We need to be a little more opportunistic on both sides of the ball. We don't need to shoot ourselves in the foot. But our guys are working hard, and they'll continue to do that. I don't see any quit in this group. These guys, I think, are fighters. You know, so we got to keep them healthy so they have a chance to fight. And that's one of the things this week we're trying to make sure in our improvement that we give them enough reps to improve, but at the same time, don't go out there and lose five guys in one day where we don't have enough guys to play.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.